Good morning, students. Today we will study complexometry titration. That is, this is a titration in which metal, which is our calcium gluconate salt, and the metal in this that salt is calcium, that will form complex with the EDTA, which is our complexing agent or chelating agent. So what happens in complexometric titration is metal forms complex with the EDTA. And it gives a pink color initially, but after more amount of indicator is added, it will give you blue color finally at the end. So we have taken EDTA, which is ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, in the burette, and we will take calcium gluconate 0.5 gram calcium gluconate in the conical flask. So this is calcium gluconate, in which calcium is the main metal, and in the burette we have taken 0.05 molar of EDTA. Now one by one we will add 50 ml of water to dissolve it. And 5 ml of magnesium sulfate to give the very sharp endpoint. This is the main reason of adding the magnesium sulfate. It will give the very sharp endpoint. This is the complexometric titration in which we are adding 10 ml of buffer also. So we have seen that our calcium gluconate has dissolved completely. Now add the indicator, which is Modern Black or Calcone mixture. These indicators are basically dyes. So now we have added all the things. Now this dye which we have added, which is our Calcone mixture or Modern Black 11. Sometimes we also use Solochrome Black and Eurochrome Black in the complexometric indicators, that we have to depend on which salt is to be analyzed. So now we have added the metal in it, which is our calcium. Calcium is the metal, and dye is this Calcone, right? The dyes or the indicators used in complexometric titration are the specific dyes, which will give initially a different color, but after the here the dye metal complex is formed. Dye is our Calcone and metal is calcium, and we got this color. But when we add this complexing agent fume from the burette, this dye metal complex will break down, dye will be separate and metal will be separate, and we will get a different color, that is blue color, right? So this is the main theory behind the complexometric titration, that initially there is a formation of dye metal complex. But when we will start titrating it with this complexing agent, which is EDTA, this dye will go separate, and this metal will react with this complexing agent to give you a different color. So one very important question asked in this titration is why we are adding buffer. Buffer, which is your ammonia buffer, made up from ammonia and ammonium chloride mixture. We are adding this buffer for two reasons. First is for the stability of this complex, dimetal complex. Second reason of adding the buffer is to give you the perfect color. right? So two reasons is for adding the buffer is stability of this complex and for giving the proper color. So we start the titration. In the burette we have taken EDTA and in the conical flask dimetal complex is there. So we'll see. Initially there was pink color, but now there is a beautiful blue color. So why this blue color has come? Because dimetal complex has broken down and now the metal is free, which is giving its own color with the help of this complexing agent, which is your EDTA. So EDTA is a complexing agent which has 6 donor atoms and it is a Zwitter ion. That means in this in the structure of EDTA, Zwitter ions means it has both positive ions on the hydrogen ions and negative ions on the carboxylic ions. So what is a Zwitter ion? Any molecule, any compound should be called as Zwitter molecule, Zwitter compound, when it has positive and negative charges in the same molecule. So EDTA is one that molecule which has positive hydrogen ions and negative carboxylic ions in the same molecule. So that's why it is giving a sharp blue color, because now it has reacted with the metal and metal has become free and we have got beautiful blue color. And magnesium sulfate is added to, in this titration to give you the sharp end point. So thank you so much for watching carefully. Thank you.